was the third actress discussed for the role of Glinda the Good Witch. Fanny Bryce, the Broadway comedian, was also an MGM contract player at this time, and the part was first planned for her. Then Noel Langley decided that British comedian Beatrice Lilly would be right for the scatterbrained, lightly laughing Good Witch of the North. He even planned to invent a gossipy neighbor whom Dorothy likes as a Kansas counterpart for the Good Witch. But Billy Burke was at MGM. This was a part similar to those that she had enjoyed on the stage, and so she became the amalgam of L. Frank Baum's Good Witch of the North and his Good Witch of the South, named Glinda in the Oz books. Actually, Glinda in the books is about 20 years younger than Billy Burke is here, but the screenwriters decided to put the parts together and simplify the story. Gilbert Adrian did all the costumes for The Wizard of Oz, and the only costume on which he seemed to stint was Billy Burke's. It's a beautiful dress, but it's a remade gown, originally worn by Jeanette MacDonald in MGM San Francisco 3 years earlier. Among the many anecdotes and legends that spring up around films as famous as The Wizard of Oz is the one that says Billie Burke didn't do her own singing here in Munchkinland. That's just not true. A vocalist named Lorraine Bridges did come in and also recorded the song, but the take used in the film was one made by Billie Burke. In fact, she did 14 versions of this.